Welcome to another edition of SmackDown. Of course, we are continuing our foreign exchange, as this week, Duel will be booking SmackDown. Duel,
and after that Raw, Duel, you have to have some kind of plans here.
As usual, I am Johnny. Alongside me is Jericho. This week's SmackDown GM is Duel, and this week's Raw GM, Hatile. But, well, that'll go back to normal next week, but...
Duel gets to book two shows in a row.
Does he? Oh, yeah, because it gets Raw. Yeah,
technically,
true.
Hatile did too, but...
Right, yeah, exactly. All right, well, if you didn't watch Raw, that happened.
Oh, yeah.
But, yeah,
yeah, that's right. It's a big shock. Xavier Woods is now on Raw.
Yeah, that too. Let's get right into the action. Duel, what do you got for us?
What's the card, brah?
Tonight, we got to start with a debut of a new superstar.
Oh,
my God.
It's one of the most hyped debuts
in
SmackDown history.
Could it be?
And it's the guy who starts at the bottom... Corey Graves.
That's not a debut.
I know, he's going to fight the guy who's debuting.
Is this just a normal match?
Yes.
Okay.
No, it's a very big match.
Oh, sorry. Corey Graves taking on...
He's going to take on the debuting Stone Cold Steve
Austin. Oh!
Boy, that young boy.
I heard about that guy from the Big Dog on the house show.
But I don't think he won.
I don't know, I didn't hear about that part.
Stone Cold ready? It sure looks like it.
Couldn't fucking understand him.
Boy, Cody Rhodes coming soon.
Don't look at Skype, okay. Let's continue on.
Alright. The next match is...
Yes.
Another singles normal match.
Wow.
Wow. Wow, fans.
Wow, fans. All right. Who's it going to be?
The possibly new sensation, Neville.
Oh!
Takes Neville. On the big enforcer.
Oh, that damn enforcer. He's so big.
Johnny Skype.
Yes, I did.
Did you?
Yep.
All right. He did wipe his butt, guys. All right. I just had to make sure.
What did you? Why are you booking that match, Duel? What did Neville do to you?
I thought I'd go with what Hatile was doing, booking Biggie every week.
Hatile hates Neville.
He just doesn't like him.
Well, he does now, I guess.
Wow, you hate Neville, Hatile?
I guess so.
Let's move on to our third matchup.
And now it's time for a triple threat match.
Whoa! Is this a normal? Oh, I guess it, Extreme Rules is default, right? I don't know why Extreme Rules is an option when it's... Whatever. Alright, who's it gonna be?
It's gonna be... General Adnan and Rose.
General Adam Rose!
Excuse me! Adam Rose! General Adam Rose!
Yes.
Is taking on...
Colonel Mustafa!
Colonel Mustafa! Is he DLC as well? Yeah. Taking on who?
Fruit Punch Paul.
Oh, the big fruity punch.
How many titles are on the line in this one? Jesus.
All of them.
All the titles.
Is also General and Colonel on the line?
I guess so.
Sure.
My God. All, like, three ECW titles, the U.S. Spinner title, the European title, and the title of Colonel and General.
Jesus.
So much on the line.
All right, our match number four.
Match number four is an Intercontinental title match.
Oh!
Get off Mark Henry.
Oh my God, you never know.
And it's a singles match.
Is it?
It is.
No, a normal match?
Extreme Rules.
Oh!
Oh!
It will be Mark Henry defending his championship.
Against Big Match John.
Bo!
John Cena!
Big Match John Cena!
Never held the Intercontinental title before.
Unbelievable.
Come on. How could you follow that one up?
I could follow it up with a world title on the line.
Oh no! Oh my God.
And I guarantee a new champion.
Oh!
With a six-man battle royal.
What the fuck?
You can almost do over the top.
Yes, exactly.
Oh no.
Oh God. Six-man battle royal.
Which main eventers are going to be in this one?
It's going to be Brock Lesnar.
Of course, because he's the champ.
Yes. Connor.
Ah, the former Ascension.
Where the fuck is Connor
Ascension? Is Connor on Raw?
Is he DLC? Is Connor on Raw? No, Victor's on Raw. Right?
I never know.
Connor.
Wasn't Connor in the match with Kano too?
No, you're thinking of the number one contenders match with Brock Lesnar.
Oh, that's right. My mistake. Oh, God.
All right, who else you got?
That cunt, Rookie Orton.
No!
Oh, what a cunt.
He's such a cunt.
He's such a cunt.
All right. Yes?
JBL.
JB Michael.
I was going to say Jey Uso.
Me too. Where is JBL? I'm blind. Oh, he's DLC, right? God damn it. So much DLC.
Not Jey Uso, Jericho. The other Uso.
I think he got fired, didn't he?
Oh, God, Eric Rowan.
Eric Rowan, of course. Sorry, we don't talk about that other Uso.
Apocalypse.
Oh, no. And last but not least...
is, of course... Sami Zayn.
Oh, the Yellow Champion.
The Yellow China also on the line.
Oh, my God.
Winner of the previous Battle Royal.
Of course.
That all makes sense.
Oh, man. Who knows what will happen tonight? Let's get right into the action here as Corey Graves takes on Stone Cold Steve Austin, debuting Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Boy, I wonder what this kid's got in him.
A lot of chutzpah.
Oh, is he Jewish?
I don't know, maybe. Corey Graves' fall from grace here. Duel continuing the trend of...
Oh, Corey God, Graves, we're in Chicago.
Corey Graves needing to fight his way back to the top. Last week, Corey Graves was on the show twice.
Is Sheamus the hardcore champion? Or did he
right
give
now, Cesaro is our hardcore champ.
Oh, yes. He won it from Sheamus backstage.
Yes,
he
did.
He's so confused.
He doesn't really know what's going on.
He's looking for blue pants in the crowd.
He's wearing blue pants.
Oh, they ruin everything.
The crowd chanting for Curfew Man Punk, but he's not on this show. He's on Raw. I told him book him.
They just want to go to bed, Johnny.
I mean, I've never...
so tired.
I've heard a lot about this Stone Cold Steve Austin, but I haven't actually seen him. So who knows what he has to bring to the table. Even if Corey Graves has watched tapes of him, he's surely forgot about him by this point.
He's only looking forward to one thing, and that's fighting Brock Lesnar for the world title and, like, fucking payback.
Oh, he's that far back, huh?
Oh, yeah. Justin Roberts awake.
Wide awake for SmackDown.
SmackDown had The Rock and Stone Cold Steve Austin. They seem like some good guys.
They seem like great guys.
Just like that Raw was great.
Ah! A scary music.
I thought I broke my glass ass.
Everyone got out of the ring, and here comes Stone Cold Steve Austin! Making his SmackDown debut here.
He looks equally as confused.
Hatal, why did you never beat Deborah? Why did you ever book Stone Cold Steve Austin?
I didn't have any spots for him.
What the fuck?
Where's his vest? That's what he's looking for.
Oh.
He's like looking back and forth on the ramp. He's like, who took my fucking vest? Oh, he's...
How do you know he has a vest? You've been watching his matches.
You saw that picture of him on the preview.
What picture? What are you talking about?
On the match preview.
What are you saying? Wrong. He sure likes to milk his entrance, though.
He sure likes to raise his fist in the air and nothing else.
He's staring a hole through Corey Graves. Justin Roberts doesn't even want to be in the ring with him.
This man is stone cold. I hear he's a master of the ring.
Who told you this?
I've been texting some people.
He doesn't look happy, though. I'll tell you that
much. The big dog saw him at the house show.
The big dog has a phone?
Yeah.
I can imagine him texting anybody.
It's a flip phone.
Well, let's start this one off, Jericho. As Corey Graves hits a nice backdrop there.
All I see is a frozen loading logo, Johnny.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, that's not what I see.
Oh, boy. The SharePlay connection has been lost.
Oh, well, let's take a quick commercial break here. Jericho, how about you?
Oh, we're going to a break already?
Fix all your shit. What the fuck's wrong with you? Unless it was me.
It says I'm now in Johnny Bud's party, the only one left.
Maybe it was me. I'm gonna blame you.
Yeah, why not?
These early commercials, Duel trying to get all that money.
But he's making money for a tile.
He might just take the money and take it to Raw.
But this money goes to SmackDown.
How do you know?
Because it's SmackDown!
You don't handle the budgets! Do ya?
They don't call me Mr. Budget for nothing.
Oh yeah?
No.
And back to the action! The Stone Cold Irish whips Corey Graves to the ropes. Corey Graves with a reversal DDT! Jericho, having cleaned his glasses off.
Yeah, they got. I was still crying from that big dog house show report. He's the best.
As Austin goes for a spine buster. No!
Oh, right on his neck!
Jesus! Does he have a history with his neck? Corey Graves does.
I believe he's had a neck all his life, John.
Has he?
Yeah.
Corey Graves lifting up the newcomer, Steve Austin. We have had a lot of debuts this week. And by a lot, I mean like two.
Oh, we did see the... We saw the Raw debut of Xavier Woods.
Lex Luger.
Yeah.
Stone Cold Steve Austin.
I was thinking we might see the SmackDown debut of The Undertaker. What happened on our last show that shocked the world?
Duel doesn't care about that. Duel's just booking to fuck a tile.
Oh, I mean, after Xavier Woods is the WWE champion, you think he'd put some worse competitors in there with Brock?
Well, that fucking first. I mean, that Connor could win the WWE title, Jericho. Oh, Corey Graves got up. Fade to irrelevancy.
Oh, this youngster Austin just doesn't have it.
Cover. Could it be it already? No. By the way, Jericho, Cody Rhodes coming soon.
Oh my god, I cannot wait.
I've heard a lot about it. I heard his
son of a plumber.
His debut is much anticipated. Can't wait to see it. It's Corey Graves. Oh, headbutts Austin. Just beating the man down. Oh, he likes to call this one the large canine.
What?
Oh god, large canine to the skull!
My god, the canine to the cranium.
Cover! One, two, Corey Graves!
Oh my god.
Cleaning house with this youngster. Next week, Corey Graves will be one match higher up the card. And there you have it. I guess Steve Austin wasn't ready for this, Jelly.
His history of having a neck all his life is surely coming to play here.
Here's this large canine.
A neck.
Jesus.
Jesus Christ, control.
There you have it. Corey Graves, your winner here tonight.
Hey.
He's so happy.
He's almost kind of got a sad tummy like dun-dun.
NXT coming back soon. That's fucking mean. I don't see the rest of those tattoos,
it's,
but I believe
it's because his hand's in a fist.
It's in his palm? The rest of it? Oh, I see. All right.
He's like, did I win the World Cup? He's looking over at a tile and Duel, but like, did I win?
Yeah, well, you did that already. You did this part.
He's like,
so dumb. Big dumb boys. Let's move on to our next contest here, Jericho.
Oh, man, this is a huge one. Duel booked it.
When I think of huge matches, there's no other match that I think of than Neville and Big E.
Oh, boy. The enforcer from the
tile. New sensation, Adrian Neville.
He is. He's still technically new. I don't think he's been in a lot of matches.
He's been in one.
To The Rock, of all people. They're big friends now.
Yeah, I've heard. I mean, who knows what could happen with them? They could go public. And here comes Adrian Neville.
Yo, Adrian.
I think he lost that match against The Rock, though.
It was a hard-fought loss.
It was a great matchup, though.
On that damned open fight night. He called out The Rock for some reason.
Who knew The Rock was even in there? In there as in the arena.
I mean, he's on the roster. He's always been there. to title.
Are you telling me he just sits back?
Anyone other than Brock Lesnar and Corey Graves?
The Rock was filming a movie, though. That's why he wasn't around.
So did he. I loved Fast 9 with Adrian Neville.
Fast 10 was even better.
Oh, but that's because that's The Rock. I heard they're going to team up for Fast 12.
Who's in Fast 11?
Justin Roberts.
Yeah?
Because he's fast asleep. That's what it's going to be called. Fast 11, fast asleep.
And here comes Hatile's enforcer. I figured a duel would keep him off the show, but I guess he wants to see what he's got. Maybe he's going to draft him, Jericho. Maybe he wants his own enforcer to take
Does
care of Sting.
Does he not have it in the form of Kano, too?
He's just lost the fucking WWE title. What does he need five of?
Now this doesn't seem right.
What the fuck? Hatile must have bought up some new threads. Here comes Big E. That big enforcer.
The big A.
Decked out in full Canada colors.
Well, he was, little known fact, born in a country next to Canada.
Yeah?
Yeah.
No shit.
But this doesn't feel right because usually Hatile sends him out to take care of his dirty business.
Well.
But there's no business here.
This is just, this is everything but business. This is just.
Oh, there's a lot of butt business going on with Big E.
Big E, big booty boys.
Neville, you look so small.
He looks so confused.
He's in front of the camera there.
Big E's been back and forth with wins and losses as of late. Maybe, maybe with a new GM in charge, he'll try to impress Duel. Come out with Australian colors.
He's only in charge for one day.
That's true, but he might want to jump shows.
Oh, I don't think Hatile would like that.
And here we go. Hatile, how do you feel about this matchup? I like the attire you've given him, by the way.
Thanks.
Oh, God.
Right to the tits.
I'm guessing you're rooting for your man, the Big A.
Of course.
But Neville's taking charge to open this contest. Rolling elbow by Neville.
Big E, not really. He hasn't gotten out of the gate yet.
Neville.
Neville is just too fast, too furious.
Maybe he's not comfortable in his gear yet.
Yeah,
I mean, looks pretty tight.
I mean, what's the big difference between that gear than he's got knee pads and nothing on his manly chest?
He's feeling very sexy tonight. He's got both titties out.
Oh, man, that's more than one titty.
Into the corner goes Neville.
Yeah,
as Big E follows it up with a backdrop. Stomping away at Neville, lifting
looks
him
like
up.
Like a big old diaper. It looks like it's filled, too.
Oh, Gordita Crunch there!
Oh.
Cheesy.
They have those in Canada?
He's got an E on his asshole. Why so funny?
Because Canada's on his ass.
Oh, Big E lifting him up. The power! Don't you dare be sour, Duel. One! No.
It's a new A. Yes, it is.
Neville struggling to get to his feet, but hits a back elbow. Tilt a whirl head scissors there by Neville.
Neville is so quick.
So fast.
Makes him the new sensation.
What makes him, or are you saying that makes him it?
What makes him the new sensation?
Oh, he's so fast.
Yeah.
Oh, big boot by Big E.
He's fast nine.
A few shots there by Big E as the Irish whips Neville into the corner. Oh, crumbling down to the mat there, Jericho.
Oh, he's crumbling so small.
Reversal from Neville. Divorce court. Jesus.
Could we see the big ending?
Excuse me?
The big ending.
One. Two. No, kick out from Big E.
That was a delayed count, ref.
I couldn't even see it.
He's in the pocket of Duel.
Maybe he wants to embarrass the Big E. The Big E.
Yeah, I mean, his fellow countryman Adrian Neville is about to fly.
Wait, what? Neville. Off the ropes he goes. Big E's. Wait, holy shit!
Oh, God, we got a flying Mighty Mouse Maggle.
A flying sensation.
Oh, he's the fly sensation. You're so fly now.
Big E.
I like Big E's long socks.
Yeah, they're great. Oh, nearly a penalty kick there, Jericho.
He must be very comfy. I'm sorry, I'm stuck on the socks.
I understand. Rolling elbow.
Oh, rolling elbow.
A Japanese tryhard, Adrian Neville.
Whoa, calm down.
Jesus! I think he wants to count out victory here, Jericho.
The ref's like, okay.
I wish I knew what the ref was at. Is that 7?
Now he's yelling at him.
He's yelling at him. What are you doing?
The ref clearly caught out by a tile.
A tile must have pinned off this referee. Oh, cover though. 1, 2. Oh.
So close.
What the hell was that? Ref? Hatal, you're not supposed to be involved with this show. You're not supposed to pay off Jake Dimmadone. Oh.
Now Big E using those big elbows.
Is that what the E stands for?
I'm not sure. What does the E stand for, Hatal? Oh, it stands for oh.
Big E going for quick covers there, though. As Neville tries to get back to his feet.
Yeah, but he's not as quick as...
Not as quick as Neville,
Big
no.
Big E's face is starting to melt.
Who's? Big E's face?
I believe so.
Cover! No, that move is not putting him away. Neville kips up!
He kips Stern! Big E's face is...
Oh,
gone.
No! What has happened? What are you feeding him, Matile?
Bagged milk!
No!
He looks like his eyes are rolling in the back of his head.
True, Joey Lawrence!
It's like an undead zombie. He's like an undead Eddie Guerrero.
What are you saying? Oh, no! Cover! 1, 2... No. Both these men going for desperation pins here. Oh, now they're both blown up.
Not even Neville is fast anymore.
Big E pulled him towards the center.
Oh! Power.
What power? Neville's definitely sour at this point. Oh, titties!
Oh, God.
A big pair of knockers to the face of Neville. 1, 2, 3.
Titties did that. Those milk bags did the job. He looks like he's drunk or something.
I mean, but if it was, I don't know, Jericho. I think Neville had that count out victory there.
Not the referee clearly biased against Jordy's.
Here's where we thought the beginning of the end was for Big E.
The arrow from the depths of hell.
He might have hurt his face there off the apron.
It was that tricep knee, as Chad.
And there goes a big dive. I mean, I don't know. I didn't hear the referee's count, but here's another.
That's a close one. Right after the not count out.
And here's the milk bags.
Milk bags.
And the 1, the 2, and the 3.
Oh, God.
He looks fine. His
eyes are all over the place.
He's fine.
He's so happy he finally gets a win for his pal, Hatal. But, yeah, I guess his eyes are back to normal.
He's slapping away those...
Yeah, just those titties we saw.
Those big milky milk bags. There you have it. Feisty. The big enforcer. Picks up a win. Feisty.
Don't you dare drink our milk. It's Oh, Chicago! Oh, yeah, this.
All the titles are on the line, Jericho.
Every goddamn title I could think of.
What titles would they be?
I think 2 ECW World titles, a European title, a U.S. Spinner title, the title of Colonel, and the rank of General.
Wow.
Big Show might have a 3rd ECW title I forgot about.
Is it 4? Yeah, I think he might. And here comes the General. Adam Rose.
Where's his belt?
I don't fucking know. Where's his rosebuds?
Oh, the party's over. He's a general now.
Wow. Whoa, oh, whoa. I like this song, Jericho.
Whoa. It's just not the same without his rosebuds.
Are you a rosebud?
Oh, all the time. I'm not a lemon.
Adam Rose has one victory, and it was an important one, as it was the match that made him the general.
Have we not seen him since?
Nope.
I don't think so. Let me see.
Because then he wouldn't be the United States Spitter Champion.
No, he is. That was the last time we saw him. That was the last time that belt was defended. He beat General Adnan. Yep.
Here comes Colonel Mustafa.
And you are right. One half of the whole fucking show.
A team that was supposed to help, like, bring peace to both brands, and yet here we have a foreign exchange causing a rift between Hatal and Duel. Except when it comes to Sting.
Hatal pounding away at those drums.
Are you ready for this theme song to be in your menu music for the next game?
Fuck that.
It's the Big Show.
See, like that sign?
It's the Big Show.
What a piece of shit sign that was.
What a piece of shit match this is.
Duel sabotaging this show. And last but not least, a man that I thought was in the New York Giants.
Fruit Punch Paul.
Fruit Punch Paul.
Where are his belts?
Big, I mean, he can't carry all of them.
Maybe he's a big man, Johnny.
Where's he gonna put them all?
In his pockets.
All right.
Has Fruit Punch Paul ever even been booked for SmackDown?
I don't know. That's a good question.
If he's 2-0.
I think he has. Yeah, he beat Rookie. Oh no, that's Big E. Oh no, he hasn't been. Is this his fucking SmackDown debut?
SmackDown debut for the multi-man champion.
Oh.
Fruit Punch Paul. And Kulo's not even here because he's still chasing down his van. On foot. So he may never show up again.
Fruit Punch Paul, obviously a man that was once known as Big Punch Paul, but the sponsorship rolled in and... Man, does he love Fruit Punch.
It's finally gonna pay off.
Or is it?
As he makes an appearance on television.
That's true.
To show those culos.
And here we go. So much riding on the line here that I can't even remember. It's a lot. There's like 5 belts.
Yeah.
And the general.
We could combine them all into one mega title.
Yeah? How the fuck you want to do that?
You just call it something new.
Big Show. Sorry, Fruit Punch Paul standing at Wade for a minute, stomping on Colonel Mustafa. General Adnan, which one is he? I forget. The Iron Sheik. Oh, fuck!
Big drop kick from Adam Rose. Adam Rose, of course, hates lemon culos.
Oh, God, I would never have one of those.
They're always so sour. Don't you dare!
Don't you dare! Big Show trying to lift up Adam Rose. Irish whip brings him back and drops him down. Oh, who do you got in this one, Jericho?
I mean, you gotta go with Fruit Punch Paul. He's got all those belts. He's the big man. Who do you got?
I don't think I can disagree with you, honestly. He's a big man. Love big men.
I didn't realize that Adam Rose was bigger than the Sheik.
I guess fucking so. Drops the elbow. Run on the liggity leg.
Stomp.
Big Show with the Irish whip. Into the corner. Oh. Controlling the matchup is Fruit Punch Paul.
I have a frozen screen of a headbutt or something.
Okay. Out of everyone, Fruit Punch Paul has the most to lose here.
Black screen. Oh. Oh boy.
Okay. Let's take a quick commercial break.
God damn it.
What the fuck? Air Station, I love you. Air Station, I hope you had a good birthday. And...
Oh, I have my birthday off. I got the night off for my birthday. What crazy adventures will happen? Probably I'll be sleeping.
Air Station, how's that thing going, by the way?
Ooh, I like his thing. The very sexy thing.
Of course, right now, on television, they're advertising Fruit Punch Paul's Fruit Punch.
It's like a five-knuckle shuffle to your face.
You guys don't see the commercials because you're live at the show. Alright, back to the action. Oh, what a shot there. Oh! Dropkick.
Dropkick Murphy.
Adam Rose has the Sheik in the corner. Because I don't feel like calling him anything but that. Oh, Jesus!
What a fruit punch! An explosion of flavor!
Rolling Adam Rose towards the center. Uh-oh, watch out! Fruit punch!
Oh, God, the explosion of taste in his face!
Oh, God, taking advantage of the situation.
Oh, my God. On top of Adam Rose.
Stretchy man. Oh,
stretchy
no.
Stretchy man.
Too close to the ropes.
And now they want to get rid of that flavor. They want to make a big fruit mess on the mat. Oh, God.
Big,
there was some strawberries.
Big
punch. Having a little raspberry.
Adam Rose sending him into the corner. Face first. Oh, right to the lower back. What's he going for here? Bulldog!
Oh, God! Sliced red!
What? That's not the same move. Clothesline! Another one!
The power of the war, I mean...
Oh! Super kick party!
His legs are not that long.
They must be. Going behind. What the hell is this?
Oh!
Jesus! Cover!
Wait a minute! Adam Rose!
A confused man. Oh, party foul!
Oh, dirty deeds!
They're trying to take the big man out.
And now he's going to throw him out of the ring and pin Big Show. I mean, Fruit Punch. Now he's going to stand there.
What an idiot.
Oh, fuck.
It's the Big Show!
Big Show!
All three men have no idea what's going on. Holy shit, over Adam Rose!
No, Adam Rose is not over.
Oh, God, his eyes! He's gouging his eyes out, Jericho!
Oh, God, the colossal...
Clutch.
Punch. The tropical crush.
And a neckbreaker. Cover. One. Adam Rose giving him a chance to at least get a one count so he felt good. Oh, nice dropkick there.
Oh, I feel good watching this match.
Do you?
Not really.
Adam Rose on the outside on the apron. Whoa! Not who I thought he was going to attack. Suplex.
Well, I mean, when you're the biggest man, you're going to get hit a lot. You're in the way.
That's true.
So clearly, Sheiky Baby here is the smallest man. So
elbow
he's going
to
win.
Back of the head. Uh-oh. Jesus!
Oh, God. The fruit cut.
Went for it again.
Oh,
S-T-O.
S-T-O.
Went to the well too many times. Oh, single leg Boston Crab. Very close to the ropes, though.
Ref is in the way!
Oh, he got the ropes, Jericho.
Adam Rose.
Yes.
Into the corner.
Belly to bell!
Oh, jeez!
God damn! Pulled him towards the center. He's probably going to pin him. Oh, he's confused. Oh!
Oh, my God!
A fruit punch! One, two, no!
Oh, so close! The explosion of flavor of seven different berries into the face of the Sheik.
Whoa!
A frozen Sheik for all to eat.
Double drop kick.
In the sky. What does it mean?
What is wrong with you?
I don't know! I love culos.
Into the corner. Goes Adam Rose. What is Sheiky Baby going for? Oh, reversal. Fruit Punch Paul lifts him up.
Into irrelevancy.
What the fuck is he doing?
The power.
Jesus.
Oh, God. That was like a cranberry to the
cover.
Mat.
No. Not even anything. What the fuck?
The strike. He did not miss leg day.
Party foul.
Oh,
oh, double team!
Oh, no, he's bleeding for a punch everywhere.
Double team maneuver. Well, oh, in the ropes.
The fruit punch culo is starting to melt all over him.
Adam Rose going for another neck breaker. They're trying to keep the fruit punch man down.
His rocking chair is very loud.
Look at that fruit punch all over his face.
Oh my god, it's so bright and tasty. I ought to go over there and lick it.
I wouldn't suggest that.
I'll pick that culo right off Big Show's face.
And now he's wiping it off on his face. Cover! One, two, three. Oh!
Oh, fighting spear from Colonel Mustafa.
Tucks Big Show under his arm. Double team maneuver. Titties!
Well, that's not going to hurt the Big Show. Fruit punch ball.
Oh, takes Adam Rose down like he's nothing.
Well, he is nothing.
Holy shit!
Oh, God, a spear of fruit flavor.
Hit him with the gusher. What the hell is this?
Happened?
Adam Rose is going crazy.
Whoa,
what the fuck?
Oh, judo throw.
Oh, this move. Devastating.
Shoulder destroyer. Punch him. Oh,
he tried it. He punched him.
Oh, his cheek doesn't know when to end the match.
Firing back. Triple threat matches, ladies and gentlemen.
Only on Duels Book SmackDown.
It's all out of triple threat as well.
He was going to go for that suck it move. Fruit Punch falls back on his feet. Oh, God, he's pumping it up.
God, he's bumping that fruit flavor.
Oh. Oh! Right to the sack.
He went for it. He went for it and he missed.
He just really wants to hit it. Adam Rose going for his finisher. Fucking never mind.
Fucking.
He really wants to hit that corner maneuver.
Let's go for the butt bomb.
Oh, no, maybe not. Whoa!
Batista ball.
Cover.
Cheek was just like, fuck.
He knew he was going to kick out.
Let's go with that.
Irish whip by Adam Rose off the ropes. Oh, small package. One, two. No.
Fruit punch ball taking his time.
He's so confident. Oh, to tango. It takes two to tango, Jericho. Holy shit!
Oh, it's just a choke slam.
Okay. But he nails it.
Just a cherry slam.
One. No. This match is for so many marbles.
I forgot how many.
At least five.
Like five titles and two nicknames.
What's the other nickname?
General and
Colonel.
Colonel.
Oh yeah.
The European Colonel. Fruit punch.
Oh!
Ball.
Huge party foul!
God! Could this be it?
Cover! One! Two! That's it! Why did he kick him in the head after?
General Colonel Adam Rose now has three ECW titles and a European title as well.
Holy shit. He did it.
He's not nobody anymore. Now he's... Oh, he went for the big choke slam punch there. Party
there's
is
the
back in town.
Jesus, the party foul. A man that size shouldn't be falling on his head like that.
This is only the first title match of the night.
And there you have it. We weren't going to make him carry that many belts to the back. General Colonel Adam Rose is your winner.
I don't really know which rank is higher.
I don't know.
I think it's General.
Yeah, I assume.
Welcome to the Revolution.
Whoa.
And up next is
another, the Intercontinental title.
Another championship matchup.
Mark Henry, much like Cameron, has held that belt forever.
Xavier Woods just tweeted about winning the belt on his stream.
Did he?
Yes. Sorry, this is an important matchup, Jericho. We need to be paying attention.
He says, ha ha ha, champion.
He's laughing.
He's laughing at Mark Henry.
Who might not be champion after this.
Nobody thinks Mark Henry can pull it out against Big Match John. Oh, he's so angry.
Oh, God. He's laughing at Duel, because Duel never expected him. I mean, Duel did draft him, though. He's laughing at somebody. Maybe Kano, too.
I don't know. Mark Henry, he shouldn't even be champion. Cesaro is the rightful champion.
You're still sticking with that title, that tables match.
Damn table!
Did Cesaro put him through a door, or did he just step out of the way? He stepped out of the way. You can't.
Oh, because he stepped out of the way, it caused Mark Henry to go through the table. Cesaro caused him to go through the table. Cesaro wins.
Are you going by Cody Rhodes' Big Show rules?
Of course.
Because that's how Big Show lost, right?
Who's Big Show? I don't know. For Punch Ball.
All right, you know what I'm talking about. Little does everyone know, Xavier Woods winning the belt is just a big advertisement for Up, Up, Down, Down. It's the merger, brother.
I feel lucky.
John Cena feels lucky, just like he does every other night.
I feel great.
I feel great about this matchup. John Cena has had a tag title before, and then him and Kofi physically lost the titles, and now he doesn't have anything.
He might have the Intercontinental. He's not even going to have a hat in a few seconds.
He has the title of Big Match.
I'm going to catch his hat. Here I go. I'm running over. Oh, I got it.
Oh my God, if he wins this, could we see the Intercontinental title?
Oh, my God. Could be.
I'm pretty sure Mark Henry also holds many titles in the SmackDown vs. Raw 2007 universe we had. The Intercontinental title is on the line, and there's no bigger con than Mark Henry. I mean that, and he shouldn't be champion.
You might get your wish. I mean, would you rather have John Cena as the Intercontinental Champion?
If he wins it fairly, yes. Mark Henry is a papper champion.
What if he cheats?
John Cena looks focused. Mark Henry looks fat.
Why are you so against Mark Henry? He's been just a dominant champion.
No, he lost to Cesaro!
Did you not see how he beat Jey Uso at SummerSlam?
That was
holy!
That's possible.
What?
Him and Jey Uso, that was a huge match.
He won by slamming Jey Uso on his butt.
I know! Big butt John.
Big butt Jey. Mark Henry's got Big Match John lifted up on his shoulders, marching around.
1,000 people watching this Intercontinental title match.
The Big Match John.
Big Match John.
Oh, Big Belly Henry.
Oh, God, that big belly coming into play here. Is it over already?
He only hit one of them. Mark Henry rocked by just one shoulder tackle by John Cena. What the hell? DDT.
John Cena with the elbow to the face of the Pepper Champion.
Pepper Champion? I don't think Mark Henry looks more like a salt guy.
Oh, I'm salty about him being champion.
You better not be sour.
Oh, don't I dare. No, I'm just salty. He lost to Cesaro.
John Cena hitting Mark Henry with a...
Then again, at least John Cena, or at least Mark Henry doesn't lose title belts.
Physically. John Cena's got Sting's bat.
Oh, why did you bring it with you, Duel? The title. Try to get that Canadian Sting.
Oh, God, right now.
This is Extreme Rules.
It is. The big skull John. What did Big Match John do to get this title match? Duel booked it.
I mean, it's Big Match John. That's true. Tried to book the most powerful man to take the title off Mark Henry.
And John Cena, a man that's very powerful. He's won, like, no matches in WWE on our universe.
Kyle took the WWE title off Kane 02 and put it on Xavier Woods.
John Cena is actually 2-2.
Oh, so he's batting about 500.
He's average.
What an average match John.
Average Joe John. Oh, he's got a steel... I mean, I want to... I would consider this kind of cheating, Jericho. You wanted John Cena to win fair.
This is an Extreme Rules match. It's well within the rights of the man.
Oh, back and forth they go.
Fourth and fourth they go.
Oh! He rattled him.
Big chair, John. Remember that big chair Big Show had?
That was awesome.
And he called it Big Show Chair.
Oh, big spine buster.
Everything's big in this match. My God, the big dog loves it.
Stomping away at the legs of John Cena. Oh, he is wearing knee pads, though. Oh, he's got him up. Jericho, he's got him up. World Strongest Slam on the knee.
Oh, that's... No, it's not.
He hit him on the knee.
That would hurt his knee. His big knee. Big knee Langston. Oh, God. Of course, our main event coming up next, a six-man over-the-top rope battle royal for the championship.
Put our table back.
Here comes John Cena.
He's going to save us. He's... What is happening? Okay.
Cena is what's for dinner.
Oh, God, kicking that monitor all around then, Jericho.
Oh, now I'll never see John Cena beat that lousy Pamper champion.
Oh, Mark Henry was going for something big there.
Oh, right below the belt, but he's so fat it covers it.
John Cena got him off. Attitude adjustment.
Out of nowhere. F you.
One.
Henry.
Two. Oh.
Literally out of nowhere.
A split second away from a new Intercontinental Champion. Voice crack, boys.
Oh, my God. Ass crack, boys. I almost pooped myself there.
Cena's got a ladder. Mark Henry looks upset. Mark Henry, a man that also has had trouble walking upstairs his whole life.
Oh, well, he kind of waddles up. Then.
Now he's dancing his way over to Cena. Cena, what? Oh, okay, never mind.
Oh, he gave up there. He's not so strong.
Uh-oh.
Ever since he lost his hair, he's just not strong anymore.
Jesus. John Cena lifting up Mark Henry. But Mark Henry, he was playing opossum.
Oh, not an opossum.
Yeah.
He could be alive or dead.
Mark Henry going under the ring. And he's got a sledgehammer.
Oh, the equalizer.
Right in the ass.
Gonna equalize John Cena. His win-loss record is already equal.
Cena with the reversal. Divorce courts.
A tile. Do you even care about the Intercontinental title?
I do.
What is this?
Oh, that move John Cena did once.
Feet on the ropes. Feet on the ropes.
Extreme Rules.
What the hell? Oh.
Oh, so close.
Oh, attitude adjustment. No, Mark Henry with the reversal.
Can't lift a man that big.
He's got...
We did it earlier.
He's lifting a man that big. Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Cena's up.
Jesus stabbed Cena in the kidney once.
Oh. No. Don't throw a clothesline! Don't throw a clothesline! Oh, no!
Four!
Four can't see me!
It's like a five-knuckle shuffle to your face, Fruity Pebbles!
Jesus!
Uh-oh.
You know what he follows that up with? We could see a new Intercontinental... Oh, he follows it up with a pinfall, of course! One! Two! No!
You idiot!
What's it gonna take? Bear hog! Oh no!
Oh my God! John Cena's body is flailing.
Oh, he tapped!
What?
Oh my God!
What? It was an attitude adjustment away from winning.
He tapped Jericho.
God, he shouldn't have pinned him.
Where'd the replays go? No replays for that match.
Where's Henry?
There's a ladder in the crowd. What the fuck
is happening?
Put that ladder. John Cena, in an outrage, just threw a ladder into the crowd.
Did John Cena threw the match? He had this match won, and he was like, "Fuck it." So feisty. That title's glitching through his shoulder.
Mark Henry, still your Intercontinental champ. Your Intercontinental champion, Jericho.
Oh, at least he won fair and square.
It's time, Jericho.
And now, in order to become a world's champion of the world, all you gotta do is throw somebody over the top rope. That's fair.
I mean, it is legal.
Oh my God, look at this lineup.
Eric Rowan, Rookie Orton, Brock Lesnar, Connor, JBL, and Sami Zayn. One man will be standing in the ring at the end of this match, and that man will be the World Heavyweight Champion. And here comes our champion, Jericho, Brock Lesnar.
What do you think if you're the Undertaker watching this match?
I think, why was I not booked?
I feel like the Undertaker is the rightful number one contender at Night of Champions. So
why?
He wants Lesnar.
Why do you think that?
Because he chokeslammed the shit out of him on the last
That's
match.
All? Corey Graves beat him up for months.
Well, if Sting is the number one contender for the world, the WWE title, why can't Undertaker be the number one contender for the world title?
I don't know.
Xavier Woods got a title shot when he got traded.
He deserved it.
You deserve it.
Have you not seen his YouTube channel? It's lovely.
It is quite lovely. Brock Lesnar, a two-time world champion. Defending it now against
Connor.
He loves cheese.
Here's a man that nearly became the number one contender over Brock Lesnar when we were looking for a number one contender for Corey Graves' World Heavyweight Championship.
It's ascended.
He has.
Whoa!
Connor could become the world champion here tonight.
Reminder that his full name is Connor O'Brien.
It is.
That's so lame. He could be Connor the Barbarian.
But he's not. He's Connor now.
He's got that mesh thing. It's very stylish.
I wish I could wear one of those.
You could.
No, I got too big of a chest.
Well, look at his chest.
He does have a large chest.
Bring on the measurements, Tile. His arm, his waist, his chest, his biceps, his triceps, his neck.
His deltoids.
36, 36, 36, 36.
Wow,
40.
He's evenly proportioned.
40!
Oh, here comes that.
Oh, God, I don't even have the music timed up. Hold on.
Wait, he has music?
Well, of course, he's a part of the Guns. They have a theme song.
Hey, I'm just learning about this now.
Yeah, I'm playing it now.
Is it?
You should be listening.
Sing it for me.
No. And here comes Rookie Orton. One half of the cunts with Seth Rollins.
Will we see the Ozone here tonight?
I hope not.
Will Connor ascend into the Ozone? This man could become the youngest world champion.
I hope not.
What? What's the problem?
I hate him.
Is it because he does the overdrive?
It's plenty of reasons. Plenty of reasons.
I mean, Brock Lesnar just won the title back 2 weeks ago. And now he's going to defend against five guys. Five guys.
Five guys. Yeah. Delicious.
Their fries are okay. Their burgers are great.
Yeah.
There are the five guys, and there are five of them.
Here comes John BL.
Oh, yeah. Last time we saw him, he was beating the crap out of Fandango. Over and over and over. I'd be okay with this man as world champion.
I mean, he does fight for what's right for every man.
He is a... Look at the... His stock market doesn't go crashing down when it hurts inside.
This man... With that limo, could
this
be
man.
The World Heavyweight Champion. Hatile, I don't know how happy you are about this match, but if you had to pick, would you have Brock Lesnar retain?
Yeah.
All right.
Well, I mean, everyone else is on SmackDown, so there's no reason to hate
yeah,
on
yeah, but
him.
I mean, Hatile seems like a very spiteful man.
I'm going to go.
Yeah.
Oh, look,
Jericho, you got to remember, Hatile had Brock Lesnar beating up Corey Graves for like 3 months just because he didn't like his pants. Duel, who do you want to win this one?
Look, Duel's just throwing money to the crowd.
That's all the Tile SmackDown Fruit Punch money.
That's his SmackDown dollars.
That's a Fruit Punch pop sponsorship money.
I'm going to go with the winner of this match. I'm going to go for the Black Horse. The Dark Horse. The Dark Horse in all this, of course, being Eric Rowan.
Eric Rowan.
Eric Rowan is going to win and become world's champion.
That is a sentence.
Where Jey Uso failed, Eric Rowan will rise.
Rise! Like Connor!
I put JBL SmackDown dollars on Connor.
Why does he have this entrance? Someone's invaded the feed. Oh, there's Eric Rowan.
Oh, it's the white sheep of the Uso family. Yeah, I said it. What are you looking at?
You're not even over that way. We're not even in our chairs.
People forgot about this, Russo, because the spotlight was on Jay.
Well, Jay did have a chance to win the Intercontinental Championship at SummerSlam, Jericho, but him and his butt didn't get the job done. And here comes the former... Wait, no, Currents, right? Current?
Yes.
Current Yellow Champion. I totally gave him the belt. I don't know why he's not coming out with it. I guess because it's not on the line.
It is on the line.
Legally, though, in-game-wise, I couldn't do this.
This is also for the yellow title. This man who's 1-0.
Oh, God, I guess it is.
One half of Mizane, of course.
Debuting soon.
A Canadian. What a happy song.
Olay. Hopefully he doesn't throw his shoulder out right here. Oh, God!
I remember when his entrance in this game was different.
Yeah?
And then they quietly switched it.
Very quietly.
Look at all the countries on it! This is a foreign exchange on his pants!
That sounds gross.
It's one of our friends here sleeping.
I don't know. Who would it be? Duel?
I don't.
What?
Hatile?
What?
What are you talking
about? Somebody's just breathing really loud.
Oh, don't know. Well, here we go.
Final on the line.
The world championship.
Oh. Yeah.
Oh, God. Sami Zayn throwing Brock Lesnar into the whole pile of people.
Oh, no. There goes Connor.
Connor being... Oh, no. Wait. Oh, God. Brock Lesnar.
The yellow and the world titles on the line.
Oh, Eric Rowan on the apron getting shoved by JBL. Rookie Orton throws Connor over his shoulder.
Like a continental soldier.
Sami Zayn just keeps throwing Brock Lesnar into people. Now he throws Brock. Oh, no, he doesn't.
What a superb.
What a hell of a backbreaker there.
Oh, haluva.
Connor gets thrown into the corner by JBL. And then a vicious spinebuster. Shades of Ron the Truth Simmons.
It's all on the line.
Backbreaker by Sami Zayn.
It's all on the line.
No, it's not. It's just one belt. Or two
belts.
Yeah, two, but one only matters, and that's the Yellow Championship.
Well, I mean, after Corey Graves has been your champion for the past, like, 6 months.
Oh, Connor skinning the cat! Oh,
no, not my pick! Not Eric Rowan!
Eric Rowan is still in it, Jericho! Connor continuously running. And he throws JBL like a sack of potatoes.
What was your thought process going into making this an over-the-top rope battle royal duel?
I couldn't make it a pinfall battle royal.
That's a very good point.
I guess that's true. Oh, no, the yellow champion!
Oh, no, that rookie.
We are absolutely going to have an... Oh, rookie's gone, too!
Oh, my God.
There will for sure be a new yellow champion here tonight.
Perhaps the runner-up can be the yellow champion.
Oh, neckbreaker!
So the world title isn't connected to the yellow
That's
title.
Fine. I'm with that.
Oh, my goodness.
Eric Rowan throws Brock over the top rope.
Of course, remember in 1990 when Ultimate Warrior was the yellow champion. He had to vacate it when he won the world title.
Eric Rowan not able to take Brock Lesnar over the top.
Oh, God.
Out of the ring, at least. JBL and Connor fighting as Eric Rowan takes it to Brock Lesnar, sends Lesnar into the corner. Connor
He's
over the top rope.
For you.
JBL trying to eliminate Connor as Brock goes after Eric Rowan.
Oh, God.
Connor.
Big red.
Both men still back, still in this matchup.
One of these four men is going to be the world heavyweight champion.
Brock Lesnar still pushing on the beard of Eric Rowan.
That's illegal. Oh, no. Big red fighting back. Big red.
Brock Lesnar is persistent here, Jericho.
Well, I mean, that's how you win the match.
Oh, God. He's shoving on his belly.
His Uso belly.
And Connor lifting JBL deadlift powerbomb into the corner. Connor's corner.
Connor's cure.
No.
third generation wrestler sign for Brock Lesnar.
JBL still going after Connor. It's Brock throws
it. The Rowan Apocalypse.
Maybe.
The greatest move in wrestling.
Brock and Eric Rowan fighting back and forth as JBL tries to eliminate Connor. Rowan tickling Lesnar in the corner. But no, Brock does not like being tickled. He does not like being tickled. Who's breathing in my ears? Oh, Connor's gone.
Oh, he has descended.
My
we are down to three.
It's down to one
I
of these.
I said it. Eric Rowan is going to be the world champion.
It's down to one of these men.
I called it.
Oh,
and
my
Brock
God.
Lesnar is gone.
Oh, my God. No. Brock Lesnar is eliminated. It's down to JBL. And
Eric Rowan.
I told you I guaranteed a new champion.
Oh, my God. JBL shoving Eric Rowan. JBL might be your new world champion. No!
Eric Rowan,
not yet!
Big Red, he's not going down without a fight.
Oh no, over the top goes Eric Rowan!
Oh, this might be it.
This could be it, Jericho! Oh no, JBL! No!
Big Red is not going down that easy.
I think JBL thought he won! JBL over the top! Eric Rowan shoving on his belly! Oh my God! Eric Rowan!
I called it! Yes!
Eric Rowan is the new World Heavyweight Champion!
Tyler, how do you feel about this?
I don't know.
There it is!
No music!
It's the beginning of the Rowan Apocalypse!
What does this mean?
I don't know.
Undertaker used to be a Hell's Gator.
Oh my
God. For a title shot.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Eric Rowan has also done the unthinkable, the impossible.
In just 1 week, this foreign exchange has shooken everything up.
Thank you for joining us for SmackDown. We will see you at Saturday Night's Main Event.
Oh God, and JBL has earned himself a yellow title.
That's true. Holy shit.
I called it, damn it. Big Red has arrived!
Big Red boys.
Oh my God. Eric Rowan is the world champion!
He
was
it.
Probably pleased with himself.
Look at this news. Wow. Let me go change these titles real quick.
We are 2 weeks away from Night of Champions. What the fuck is going to happen?
I don't know. Oh my God. Look at this picture. Oh my God. Okay. I need all the belts because I need to change them now. So what was the belts that Big Show had?
All the ECWs.
All of them?
No, the World Heavyweight. All three. I think there are three World Heavyweights.
We got to give Adam Rose. That one. Did he have the European title?
Yeah.
This one?
Yeah, those two.
Okay, these two, okay. And is that it?
Yeah. Okay. Oh, and JBL gets the yellow title.
Right, where's that at?
It's one of the Intercontinentals.
This one? I totally gave it to him earlier. I don't know what happened.
Yeah, but remember they took all the titles off everyone for some reason.
No, but then I put it back. And I did it again. Wow.
Wow, fans. We're not done because... Oh, wait, go back to the titles.
Oh, shit, sorry.
I need to see what titles are going to be on the line.
1 second.
At Saturday Night's Main
Oh,
event.
Yes, of course.
Oh, my game is frozen.
Oh. Well, while we decide that, we'll take a quick amount of time.
Oh, yeah.
Damn it. I don't know if it's me or you.
I mean, my internet stopped going out.
It keeps saying I leave the party. I don't know. Oops.
We got 2 weeks to book a show of 7 matches with every title on the line.
I invite you.
Surely Adam Rose is going to have to be on that card. I am in.
Okay. Big red boys.
Clifford the big red dog. Finally, the era of Lesnar and Graves is over.
As far as we know.
I mean, John Cena was world champion, but we skipped that one.
What better reason?
Oh my goodness, let's see. Go back to go up one more time slowly. We're running out of shit. So I say we go.
Oh, wait,
why
that,
is
somebody
smoking
has...
skull in the Brahma Bull?
See,
empty?
I gave them to him earlier. I don't know why. We know who the champs are there, though.
We're going for the WCW World Heavyweight Champion.
What, this one?
No.
Oh, this one. This one, okay. All right. Well, let's get right into the action.
Oh my goodness! And then Victor, he was so proud of Khan for how he did, but he's like, I gotta do my own shit. And he won against the Helmsley. And the big dog left it. Oh man, the Divas champion. Going against our former champion on the main event of Saturday night. Cause you're staying home to watch it because you don't got a girlfriend. And then the girl, oh my goodness, two tactical wrestlers. I love that Christian going against that great Cali, the New York Giants. And then Christian won because I love him. And then the big dog taking on the big dog. And the big dog won because I love him. And oh God, why they, oh, he finally gets on TV, but ain't nobody going to give a shit. Oh man, the Intercontinental Champion John Cena going to get your Hipka.
He's not the Intercontinental Champion, big dog.
Oh, God, I've read the wrong SmackDown spoilers, that song, bitch. And Hoopka, he's going against Hoopka, and Hoopka won. And for the WCW World Championship, it's going to be Batista and Dan O'Brien.
Of course it is.
Because they lost all their other belts.
Yeah, I don't know why. Oh, they did. They actually did lose them, didn't they?
Did they?
I don't know. What belts did they
have? I meant physically lost them.
Yes. What belt is it? I can't remember. Oh,
WCW
yeah.
World, bro.
Where the hell's that at?
It's up with the world titles.
Oh, yeah. There it is. Batista. And Brian. Which Brian is it? This one?
Yeah.
Let's get right into the action.
The big dog loves it.
Filthy Animals did not break up. This is just for the gold.
We're on the gold, sucker.
Why doesn't it say the title's on the line? Who knows?
Because it's implied.
Not only is it implied, it's allowed.
It's allowed.
Oh, and here comes one third of the Filthy Animals. The animal, Batista. Yeah.
What a filthy man.
I don't know who I have in this one, Jericho.
I'm going to go with the Filthy Animal.
They're both so similar. Under the tutelage of the Ultimate Warrior. I don't know. I don't even know who the Ultimate Warrior preferred.
Maybe that's what this is about.
Is this a Raw match?
No. Yes. Maybe.
A place where no one follows him.
To Warrior University.
Ugh.
What a Saturday night's main event is, Ben, Johnny.
I heard all about it from the big dog.
We were here.
Oh, yeah, right, yeah, yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah.
What are you doing watching the recap before the match?
I only listened to the big dog.
I saw Christian and Kali pull out one of the greatest matches I've ever seen.
Yeah, how'd it go?
450 splash from Christian.
Whoa.
From the top of two ladders.
Top of, how'd he do that?
Kali was somehow under the floor.
That's unbelievable.
That's because I lied.
Wow! And his opponent and partner. But not for this matchup, of course.
I mean, this one's for all the WCW marbles from 1993 to 1994. Or 91, I think.
Daniel Bryan. Also under the tutelage of the Ultimate Warrior. He's saying no, he doesn't want to partake in this matchup, but he has to, Jericho.
Because whoever books the show says so.
He says no! Oh, this fruit punch.
The fans say yes.
What do you say, Jericho?
I say we're going to go with the filthy animal. I say also, I'm very hungry, but I'm not going to get food because I want to watch this match.
Like a true professional.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
Also, I love Dick Ebersole and NBC.
What?
Are hosts for this show.
Oh, are they?
Yes. I love NBC. It's got such...
WNBC. WNBC.
What the fuck are you
talking about? WNBC.
What the fuck are you talking about? I only know of MSNBC, the only trusted news network for filthy animals. Oh,
hey, whoa! Hey!
What the fuck?
Hey!
Alright!
Alright! Fancy graphic boys!
I don't think that existed in 1991.
That was a big match! Gets a graphic and everything! Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for tuning in for this big fight! Big fight!
Wow! It's a big fight, big fight!
And here we go! Daniel Bryan, Northern Lights Suplex.
I'm pretty sure one of these guys has a title already.
Probably.
I believe it's Batista.
But you know how this game likes to fuck me right in the ass.
Batista might have the Brahma Bull title.
Probably. I don't know. The game just takes him away.
Well, that's why he's fighting for a new one. A more prestigious title.
How do you think Sting feels about this matchup, Jericho?
Sting?
Well, I mean, he is... the master of all things, WCW.
Oh,
he turned the US.
He was probably planning on winning the WWE title and turning it into this one, but it's too late for that.
Oh, God. Backdrop by Daniel Bryan, lifting the big man back up, and another backdrop. Whoa.
That man is running down the stairs.
German suplex. Oh, all hung up in the ropes there. Thank you, K-Treads. Oh, drops him right down. Sit down in the front row, please. No reason to stand up when you're in the front row. Front row. Oh, black hole slam from an Ultimate Warrior man.
Oh, my God. That's a pit of danger.
Oh! These are just two tough dudes going hard, Jericho.
Two filthy animals going at it.
Bryan pulling Batista towards the center. Gooch driver.
Oh, right in the gooch. Right in the hooey.
The hoo-ha. Oh.
The hooey-ha.
Batista back on his feet.
All right. Oh, well, there's a fan in the front row, the second row, with an illegal yellow shirt. We got to get him out of here.
Illegal yellow shirt? Oh, I didn't even see that. Oh, elbows by Daniel Bryan.
Can we give him, like, a Sheamus shirt?
What's wrong with wearing a Han Mania shirt?
Oh, of course. Yes. On my... the Moaki.
Oh, dropkick attempt there by Daniel Bryan. Oh, Batista just punched him in the face. STO.
That might be a Lance Hoyt shirt.
Yeah? No. Oh! Out of nowhere! One! Crucifix pin! No, only a one count.
Will they shake hands after the match is what I'm asking.
Who knows?
Something usually happens at the end of these matches.
Things have gotten weird with the filthy animals, Jericho. Holy shit! I mean, we saw what happened with Daniel Bryan and Ultimate Warrior when they were facing off against the Hell's Gators. Daniel Bryan just loves discus lariats. Uh-oh. Standing on the legs there. Oh!
Oh, God. Good thing he had those knee pads.
You think Ultimate Warrior's knee pads are enough?
Well, has Ultimate Warrior ever broken his knees?
You'd know better than I would.
Bullshit, I would.
All right.
He was WWE champion before I was born.
Bryan turning Batista around. Oh, Batista. Switching positions. Oh, big Tommy punches.
Best your striker in the filthy animals.
Oh. Whoa, launching him! Beale Street! And
put your sign down.
Neckbreaker from Daniel Bryan. Lifting Batista up.
Remember when we had tag team titles and these guys would compete for them?
No! No!
Oh,
no!
Okay.
Kick to the head of Batista. Cover!
Could be it.
It absolutely could be. No, it is not.
Oh, that looked like a fast three count to me.
That was a two count, though.
That was like a one, two, three.
Batista. He's got it. Got some fighting spirit here, Jericho. Turns Daniel Bryan around. Oh.
Right to the good.
Oh, God, just driving that tassel into the face of Daniel Bryan. The disrespect.
Oh, that must make his nose so itchy.
Oh, itchy nose strats. Bryan kicks out before a one.
He's not blading. He's just itching his nose.
Bryan! Oh, the yes lock!
Oh, God. Distrucity on his side.
I've heard he likes to call this the Warrior's Way. He taps out!
Oh, wow. Who told you that?
Oh, he did. Daniel Bryan, your new
with the belt.
WCW World Champion.
He made Batista tap out and won a world title.
There's the no kick.
He did it for the Warrior. He did it for Dana Warrior.
And there it is. Batista with
tassels.
Look at those tassels. Good lord.
Tassel
what
prick.
What the fuck? And here it is, the Warrior's Way. Look at those tassels.
I thought it was going to be called the Yes Skronk.
Nope. You don't
either
make the
either way,
names.
The Warrior's Way does it.
And there
and
you
Daniel
have it.
Daniel Bryan.
There you have it.
Can't believe it.
The crowd are saying no. They hate this.
One.
Well, thank you for joining us for Saturday Night's Main Event, everybody. He's doing some inappropriate things, but we won't worry about that. We will see you.
He's just a filthy animal.
We'll see you at Raw.